Hey guys, it's Anna. Welcome back to my channel. So I'm jumping right into the tutorial here for you guys. So I'm starting off with this white cream face paint, and this is just from a Halloween store. And I'm taking this right where my eye sockets are. So I felt out where that bone was and I just outlined it, and then I'm gonna go ahead and fill in all of my skin underneath it. As you can see, this paint is super streaky, but I'm just trying to fill in all of my skin so that there are no gaps. Then I'm just gonna pick up a makeup wipe and I'm gonna carve out a little triangle on the nose where I want the black to be. And then I'm gonna go ahead and pick up a black face paint and draw on the nose. So you're just gonna go down the sides and around the tip, and then there's gonna be two triangles at the top. So now I'm taking that same black paint on a little tiny brush, and I'm concentrating the heavy part of this black right where it dips in the eye socket, and then I'm blending it outwards as the product kind of fades off of the brush. Okay, now we're going to take that black paint and just paint on the very insides of your lips so it just looks dark in there, so that we can draw this line out of the sides of our mouth. So this is where we're extending our smile. I just kind of felt where my teeth were and then drew that exact line, because this is going to be where your teeth are sitting. Next, I'm kind of feeling out my cheekbones and where the hollows are so I know where to draw them. And then I'm taking that black paint and very lightly I'm going to start sketching exactly where the bone is and where the hollows start. I'm also feeling out where the jawbone is and filling that in as well. So we're creating where the two bones meet. So next I'm taking that black paint and starting to fill those places in so that it pushes them backwards. I'm going to start by filling it in towards the center, and then we're going to fade it out. So I'm just going to be taking the side of my brush and kind of feathering it out. And then once the paint gets thinner and there's less products there, you can take the flat side of the brush and really start just blending. Alright, so next I'm starting with the teeth, and I'm going to start by drawing a really thin black line down the center of both of my lips. Then I'm going to start going like the distance where my real teeth are, and I'm going to try to keep that distance the same for all the teeth. So you're just lightly drawing lines all the way down the smile. And really try to make these lines really thin if you can. Some of mine were kind of thick and it got harder later, and I really wish I had a thinner brush. So use the smallest brush you have, because it'll make it so much easier when you start making the actual teeth. Also keep in mind that throughout this whole process, it's really helpful to have a reference picture. So I was just looking at pictures on Instagram and going off of those. Okay, so now I'm going in and creating the actual shape of the teeth, and this is the hardest part of the whole thing. So what you're going to want to do is kind of round the edges and then bring the outsides to a tapered shape, kind of like a raindrop. It gets easier as you go. You can kind of start seeing it come together, but it is kind of hard at the beginning. So just try to, again, use a really small brush and a small amount of product. Okay, now I'm taking a different brush with some black eyeshadow on it. And what you're gonna wanna do with this is take this, the darkest in between the teeth, and then you're gonna wanna fade it upwards. So I really concentrated that under where the curves were on the teeth and right between them, and then you're just gonna wanna fade it up. This is just gonna make those look really realistic and pop out. And again, this was like the hardest part for me, so really just take your time. The more shading you do, the more realistic it looks, and it just turns out so much better. So once I'm done shading between the teeth, I'm taking some of that shadow and just taking it into the middles of the teeth. This is going to create some imperfections, some cracks, or even like the perception of some roots in the teeth. I think it just really brings it to life and adds a lot more depth. Then going back in with that white face paint and just cleaning up my edges because they got a little messy. Alright, now we're doing some more shading. So I'm drawing a thin line just a little bit above that cheekbone area, and then I'm taking just what's on my brush and from that line and just blending up. This looks so cool when it's finished, so just really take your time and make sure it's blended out. I'm also doing that under the eye socket and blending downwards with this one. I'm then doing the exact same thing in the jawbone. Really try to keep your darkest colors right at the top and then blend it downwards. It's such a cool effect that it makes. And that is it. The half skull makeup is done. If you guys want to see how I did my eye makeup, go ahead and check out my last video. It will be linked down below. So that is it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys. Put your hands in the air, praise the life he spares, spare. Forget that he's the sun, he should be the only one, Stand up and not testify, he healed my mother's life.